program is how to regularize your status every Saturday at 2 p.m. Good morning. My name is Tokubola Agbaye. It's for real. How to settle the Nigeria in the diaspora and in the UK. How to settle them. How to assist them. How to make sure that they understand what they need to do on time so that they don't caught off by the law. That is my program on the radio, dated back over 10 years. So if you're one of them in the UK and you think you want to regularize your status, why don't you give me a shout? Tokunbola Agbaye, qualified solicitor of the Supreme Court of England and Wales. Ishelo Bonche, Tonto Kamila, Olevisoye. So if you have any problem bothering your mind, I think you should call on my program. Or you can phone my office on 0208-309-8808. 0208-309-8808. It's all about regularize your status in the UK. So if you have anything that you want to discuss, bothering your mind, it's an opportunity for you. That is an arena to discuss your problem with me. But I would advise people to phone into the office and book appointment to come and see me, because I am not a free lawyer. I am not a charity lawyer. I'm a private lawyer. I went to law school in the UK, so I'm qualified in the UK, and I paid so much for my overhead to be able to establish myself. So therefore, I'm not a free lawyer, but I love Nigeria at heart, and this is the reason why I'm giving that information on the public. You know, I put it to the public domain so that people can benefit and they can tell each other. It doesn't have to be you. It could be anyone that is related to you. The crucial thing is that just tell them to contact me, come and get advice. As you can see, it's a new dimension, new system, new everything. Tokunbola Agbaye, Eyemiju Kinjasa. Pe mi, anything to bother my mind there. Lori oro we gbelu. O da le se pe lori oro pe boya o loko. There is a problem with regards to getting the paper documents to establish yourself because of domestic violence. Go and look at my other program on women empowering women. Women empowering women. That is to do with domestic violence. Violence against women and children. It's a program that is at my heart over 20 years, and I have a master's degree particularly on that topic, and that is why I established that program, Women Empowering Women. And my interest at heart on that is to make sure that women are free from violence, they have their self-esteem, they restore their self-confidence, but everything is done privately. There is nothing coming on public domain when it comes to dealing with the issue of women facing violence and involuntary public life, because it's a problem in a private household that has to be dealt with privately. So don't expect me to bring my client's problem into public domain. But if you have issues, it can be dealt with privately. And I can refer you, make reference, refer you to where you need to go to get accommodation, to get things regularized. As I said, we are discussing with the government at the moment to make sure that we can get something done to assist those who have overstayed their visa. Because currently, the government is taking care of those who have papers and those who marry to those who have papers. But that is not what we want. When it comes to the issue of human rights at heart, I will spend all my time to make sure that it's done properly, because I'm a human rights activist. So I have all time, all day, anytime, to make sure it is done properly. And when we talk of violence in a domestic household, especially in relation to the immigration matter, it is not only women facing violence. Some men are also into the problem. Men are also facing violence. But what is most important is that because women are a weaker vessel, so they see them as people that are vulnerable. They are the sex that is more vulnerable and most likely have that problem. But men are also facing problems when it comes to the issue of regularization of their status with a partner that has papers in the UK. So I will be discussing at length on Saturday, by God's grace, relations to how to settle down, how to make applications, how to counter the problem of Brexit issues, how to deal with Europeans coming in, to, you know, how to assist them in terms of settling them down, registration of their documentation, get it right. We will be talking about so many things on Saturday. So I want people to be at alert and wait for me at 2 o'clock. See, my program is that it doesn't matter the numbers of people that come to view it. What matters is those that easily need my program and can get it easily at any time. That is what is more important to me. I don't care about the issue of 500 viewers or 600 viewers or 1,000 viewers or 50 million viewers. I care about the information at large, making sure that it reaches those that needed it mostly. You know, that is what my priority. My priority is to make sure that my information goes to those who need it mostly. One, a lot of people on Facebook, but I'm talking about Facebook, I pass it once more. That's what is important. And it's over born yet. People have 500 million viewers. I'm not interested. I'm interested, but I want to need it. You know, I want to need it. I know what's important to me, and that is what I want to cater for. But as you can see, it's a new dimension. It's a new 2017. Any problem relating to how to regularize your status? That's my stand. That's my area. That's the no-go area. That's what I really have passion of about Nigerian art. But like I said, Britain made me. So if there is a problem, there is war. And I'm saying it categorically. Britain made me. Britain made me. Apart from being born on the soil, it's also regularized my status. It makes my life better. My status is something that I have at birth. But Britain made me. Britain organized my life. Britain put me to reach to understand who I am. Britain gave me the self-esteem, self-confidence. Because there are so many times that people like us that are born in Britain, that were in Nigeria, many of them are lost in Nigeria. They don't even know what to do. But we thank God for His grace and the opportunity that we have to be here. So I will always want to make sure that I abide with the law, do everything correctly. So I really want to assist Nigeria that are in diaspora here. If you are in diaspora with us, you are a Nigerian, you haven't regularized your status, contact me. I don't do free advice. As soon as I'm offline, you have to book an appointment to come and see me. I am a private lawyer. I am not a charity lawyer. I am a private lawyer. But I am so passionate about giving that information. Education is power. Wisdom is so important, to give knowledge. The book of Hosea says that my people perish because of lack of knowledge, lack of information. When you have information at hand, you know what you are doing, but there's not much time to spend on here. I have to return back to work. My office number is on 0208-309-8808. Good morning, if you are hearing me, all of you over there. Good morning to you. Blessed morning. Have a good Thursday. Enjoy your day, whatever you are doing. Do it well. Ishe lo gu ishe. Ishe lo matan ishe. So double, good day back, bye for now.